Okay, I got the first one cut, and I think it went real well. And what I did here is, you know, you can see I got these stops at each end, and I had to move them a couple times just to get everything exactly perfect. Well, really close. I'm just going to finish it off with my Makita and a little tiny veining bit. I'll just go ahead and square out those corners and then just finish it off. I don't really want to do too much with a chisel in laminate, so. But you can see here where I've got it marked right here. So that's going to be, when I bring it over to this side here, that's going to be very, very close to, you know, to where my cut line's going to be. I mean, very, very close. So I came up with a very novel way to, well, it's probably not novel. I'm sure other people have done this too. For me, it was novel because I had to kind of come up with it on the fly. But I'm using these three pieces of steel here. This is my Precision Sterrett straight edge. This is a piece of 3/4 by 3/4 inch solid aluminum bar. You've seen me use this to set up my T-square. And then this is a piece of 3/16 stock. And so I was lucky to have a piece of 3/16 because this is 3/4. The slot is 1 1/8. So the difference is 3/8 divided by 2. So that means I need to offset 3/16 off the track to get a perfect alignment. So I'm going to go ahead and take this one apart and clean my corners out and make sure that I did not overlook something, you know, as far as depth goes or what have you, and then I'm going to move on to the next one. But let me show you some close-ups of some of the cuts, some of the end cuts and stuff here. So here's, you know, this is how close I cut to the cast iron here. You know, pretty close. You know, I didn't go nuts. You know, that's going to be pretty easy to clean out and break away. And then here's my, that's how close I cut to my scribe line there. So that's going to be pretty easy to straighten out too. And I just used these stops. And you can see that I had to move them back a couple times, just tweak with them a little bit. And I just got into my drawer. I needed a 1/2 inch plywood to work with the bolts and the T-nuts that I had for this. And so I could not find a scrap of 1/2 inch plywood, so I just got into my table saw bucket and took out some old 1/2 inch 12 millimeter table saw inserts. A couple holes in them is not going to hurt them. This one's definitely worn out anyway, so that's only for the trashiest of the trashy. This one I think has only been used once, but I'm going to drill holes in here anyway for dust collection, so it's fine. Okay, well let me take this apart and see what it looks like. You know, hopefully I'm gonna have good news when I come back. Okay, well here's my setup. So you can see I've got this 3/4 inch bar in the miter slot, then I got 3/16, and then I got all of these clamped together with my Sterrett straight edge on the outside. So you can see I can move this and get it where I'm nice and relaxed. And you see I've got this stuck off a little bit farther there. So that's gonna kill to that. And I can bring this up so I can mark my end right off the actual piece. And so what I also want to clamp this end down so when I'm marking it, I'm not gonna jiggle or shift it at all. So I'm just gonna use this as kind of a step clamp setup here. And okay, so I'm gonna have to get up on top of this table to do this right. Maybe I'm going to mark this in. Well, this is just really, you know, this is just real critical marking, and I don't want to. So I'm just using an X-Acto knife. I've sharpened it each time I do a line because this laminate is very, very abrasive. Here, I think I can do most of it like this. You know, and again, when you're marking, you always just want to start off light. And don't try to make your mark all in one thing. So you start off light, you form a little trough, and then each one will widen that out. And so
it gives you a runway. If you try to do it too much in one, you'll make it. It still looks okay. I'm not really nuts about marking against my Steric, but I don't really have a choice in this manner. You know, I have to do it. I'm gonna go sharpen this X-Acto. That laminate just ate the tip off of this. So I'm gonna go sharpen this, make sure my mark is good, and then I'll shift this over to the other side. Okay, I don't need this because I've already marked the end. This is how I keep my Steric. So as soon as I'm done with it, I put it back in its little place like this. I know a lot of people stand it up on their edge and there's actually marks here, but I don't have room in my shop where I feel comfortable, where I wouldn't knock it down and damage it. So I just keep it in this setup like this. And it's got a locking screw here. So even if I fumble and drop it, it's protected inside this wood. And like I said, I wish I had a better place to keep it, but I just keep it in my big tool drawer.